Hello class, in video series of database management system, today we'll be studying the database languages. As everyone, whether a human being, animals, they require a language to communicate. We require language to communicate our message, to ask for anything or to reply for anything. Similarly, a database management system also need an interface to interact with the user, or a language, or as being a user, we need a language to interact with the database. How we can access our data which is stored in database management system, how we can fetch our data using any language. So database also need or languages or interface to express the database queries, okay, so that the user can insert the data whenever want, delete the data, or whenever want can make any kind of modification in the data. Database languages can be used to read, store and update the data in the database. We have four types of database languages: DDL, DCL, DML and TCL. DDL stands for Data Definition Language. Data Definition Language is used to define the database structure, the schema of the database, the overall view of the database, how the database will be stored. So in DDL, create, alter, drop and truncate command comes. Create is used to create object in the database, to create stored procedure in database, to create table in database, to create index in database. So it is used to create object in the database. Alter is used to alter the structure of the database. If you have created a table, then to alter the structure, the overview of the table, we will be using alter command. Drop is used to delete object from the database, and it cannot be rollback. Rollback means once you have make the changes, you cannot roll back. Drop command. In drop command, the overall structure of the table is dropped, is removed. Truncate command is used to remove all record from the table. Okay, truncate is used to remove all the record. Like if your table consists of 50 records, and once you have run the truncate command, all the 50 records of the table will be deleted, but the structure will be there. Records are deleted, but structure is still there. These are the syntax of these command. Create command syntax is create table. If you are creating a table, then create table, name of the table, and then comes all the columns. Here before ID we should have open braces. Sorry, in this PPT it's miss out there, but after user you will be having a open bracket. So the syntax, so here create, we have created a table called user. The columns of this table are ID, which is a primary key. Primary key means, we'll be studying keys later, but as of now you understand primary key is the key which is unique, jo repeat nahi ho sakti hai. And auto increment means automatically it will increment key +1 +1, and int is the database and 16 is the size. Then name. Next column, first column was ID, second column is name. Data type is varchar and size is 255. Not null means name cannot be null. Every user should have a name. So this, we have created a table user which have two columns, ID and name. Then the syntax for drop command is drop name of the object here is table, what you are dropping, whether the object, what object you are dropping. So here drop table, name of the table is user. So once I have written drop command, this drop command, so this table user which have column ID and name will be deleted. After deleting the after dropping the user table, अगर आप check करना चाहोगे that what is अगर आप select query use करोगे, check करोगे कि table database में है या नहीं है, तब आपको output क्या आएगा, that table or view does not exist. ठीक है, वहाँ से हट जाएगा. Then alter. In alter we are doing what? We are making changes in the structure. So here in user table we are adding a new column called last name. Initially our table have only two columns, ID and name. Now by using alter table, our table will be alter. Now by using alter, our table user will be having three columns, ID, name and last name. Okay, and we have written a command alter table, name of the table user, add column, name of the column is last name, data type is varchar and size is 255 and it is also not null. Okay, then truncate user. User is your table name. So once you have run the command truncate user, ab aap jab chalaoge select command ki select star from your user table, your table user, then the output will be no row selected. Aap difference dekh rahe ho? जब आपने ड्रॉप टेबल चलाया, जब हमने ड्रॉप टेबल चलाया तो हमें आउटपुट क्या आया, दैट नो टेबल और व्यू एग्जिस्ट, यानी कि पूरा टेबल अब डेटाबेस में कहीं भी नहीं है. बट जब आपने ट्रंकेट चलाया तो आपको आउटपुट क्या मिलेगा, नो रो सेलेक्टेड, मतलब टेबल है लेकिन एक भी रोज नहीं है. तो ट्रंकेट आपने यहाँ भी जैसे पढ़ा था, ट्रंकेट क्या करता है, रिमूव करता है सारी रो को, और ड्रॉप क्या करता है, रिमूव कर देता है ऑब्जेक्ट को ही. Then data manipulation language, DML, it is used to manipulate the data. Select, it is used to retrieve data from database. Insert, it is used to insert the data in database. Update, used to update, and delete is used to delete the record. You can record one, you can delete one row as well as multiple rows also. ठीक है, और truncate क्या करता है, सारी rows एक साथ delete करता है, और delete में एक भी row delete कर सकते हैं और एक से ज़्यादा भी. This is the syntax of the commands. Select syntax is select name of the column, then from student. Here I have written star, star means select all the columns. Table में जितने भी columns हैं सारे columns select करते. अगर मुझे सिर्फ ID select करना था, then I will be writing select ID from student. Okay, then insert. Insert command is insert into name of the table. Here name of the table is student. So insert into student, the name and the last name, are the columns. Insert into student name, comma this and values. What values were inserting? Dolly Rana. That means this table will be having one row, first row which is Dolly Rana. Then update. In update command we'll be doing what? Update student, that is the name of the table. Set, what value you want to set. Now change last name. Previously my last name was Rana, now I am making it Kandari. Set last name equal to Kandari, where किसका last name change करना है, where name equal to Dolly, यानी कि जिसका नाम Dolly था उसका last name आप क्या कर दो, Kandari कर दो. This is update command. And delete from student, delete करो table में से where name equal to Dolly, यानी कि किसको delete करो, जिसका नाम Dolly है उसका record delete करो. Then data control language is your DCL. It is used to retrieve the stored or saved data. या तो आप रिट्रीव करते हो या तो स्टोर करते हो सेव डेटा को. द डी सी एल एग्जीक्यूशन इज ट्रांजैक्शनल. द डेटा कंट्रोल लैंग्वेज एग्जीक्यूशन इज ट्रांजैक्शनल. इट इज़ ऑल्सो कॉल्ड रोल बैक पैरामीटर्स. ओके, इट हैव टू कमांड्स, ग्रांट एंड रिवोक. ग्रांट इज़ यूज टू गिव द परमिशन, गिव द प्रिवलेज, गिव द एक्सेस टू द डेटा बेस. एंड रिवोक इज़ यूज टू टेक बैक द परमिशन, टेक बैक द प्रिवलेज फ्रॉम द यूजर. Suppose I have created a user, okay, dmy tro at the rate localhost, this is the name of the user and identified by 123, okay. Then, मुझे अगर user को permission grant करनी है, तो the command for grant is grant all privileges. That means, grant all means we are giving all the privileges. Insert, update, delete, every privilege we are giving to this particular user. And in revoke, we are just revoking all the privileges. Okay, so this grant and revoke we won't be using in practical okay? You won't be using it in practical, it's just to study the syntax. So next comes your transactional control language. Yani to control the transaction, we have certain commands. Those are commit, rollback. We have one of the transactional, we have save point also. Okay, the syntax for this is insert. Syntax for commit is like once you have written any command, like for example, I have written insert command. After insert, when I'll write commit, that means whatever I have inserted in the table is inserted permanently. Now it cannot be deleted. Okay, or it when you switch off the computer, it won't get deleted. Okay, in Oracle 10g, which is in your college installed, once you write the transaction and switch off the laptop or the computer, next day when you come and open the computer, you won't be able to see the changes, but you won't be able to see the queries that you have written. But once aap jab usme apne kaam karte ho, usme commit likhte ho, commit likhne ke baad wo save ho jata hai. Commit is used to save the transaction. Okay? And rollback is used to undo the transaction. Commit is used to save the transaction and rollback is used to undo the transaction. Save point aapka kya karta hai? Save point आपका टिल एनी पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट जस्ट सेव द ट्रांजेक्शन. रोल बैक सेव पॉइंट ऑल्सो, बट रोल बैक कैनॉट रोल बैक योर कमिट ट्रांजेक्शन. ओके, दैट्स ऑल इन योर डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम लैंग्वेजेस. दीज ऑल आर द कमांड्स विच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Once if one is studying database management system, one must know about all the commands. Thank you.